My question is kind of about Jack's character development. I think a lot of people here who could relate to Jack kind of related to the fact that despite he had never done anything evil, he was kind of labeled as evil and bad from the moment he entered. And to see that he was not bad and see him grow from his mistakes was really special for me because of how I related to Jack. So I guess just my question is, what was your favorite part about watching Jack grow?
Well, it's tough to watch yourself. I think my favorite part of him, I guess, developing was when he kind of finally accepted who he was, which wasn't good or bad or evil or, you know, the son of the devil. I think when he was his happiest, he accepted that he was a Winchester, you know? So I think for a lot of us, and I don't want to speak for everyone in the crowd, but, you know, sometimes a real blessing is your chosen family, right? Because not everybody gets, we're not all born with good parents or families that way. And Jack kind of got to have his chosen family, which I know a lot of you guys have had, and getting to choose this family. So yeah, I think that was my favorite part for Jack when he, you know, I love that I'm talking like it's him. I was like, oh, it's me, yeah. When I was like, when he was like, I'm a Winchester. I did it better on camera. It's fine. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Jenny, and yesterday I asked Misha where Cass would take Jack, and he said mini golf. I was wondering, as a follow-up, what kind of board games you'd teach Cass.
Did I ever get to play board games in the show?
You played Connect Four.
We did play Connect Four. I think we were both very baffled by it. What's a good board? I mean, nothing like, I don't feel like he'd be excited about Monopoly. I feel like he'd be more excited with like an action-based game,
like
you know?
A video game?
Tortigo?
Yep, that'd be fun. How about a Star Wars video game for Jack? Although I think Castiel would really struggle with the idea of a video game. You know? Why? Why are we these characters? He has time to teach him? Well, me and Misha now have an eternity, right? After we get done with the paperwork and, you know, then we have so much time to play video games. It'll be great.
Right.
Thank you.
So I was wondering if Jack could have had an ending other than becoming God, what would you have liked it to be?
Kind of a tough one to answer. Once you're God, I mean, what's kind of secondary to that, you know? I'm unsure. No, I really liked his ending. I really felt like it completed the arc from, you know, the start of his character to where he ended up. Yeah, if you have infinite power and wisdom, I mean, what would you want to do? Maybe like ride a tricycle or something, right? Do you have any suggestions for Jack or what he could have done?
I mean, I just would have liked Jack to be able to be a kid.
Yeah, I've definitely said this before, but yeah, he never really got a childhood. He never really got to like experience that as a kid. He was kind of forced upon really early to kind of have to compete in a very bizarre world. Yeah, it would have been nice for him to be a kid. But, you know, I don't write the show, so. Also, that probably would have been as exciting, where they're, like, solving crimes, and they're ripping around the Impala. They're like, oh, we gotta pick up Jack from preschool, like. It's not really as exciting, I think, where I'm like, where they're like, hey, let's give this fucking three-year-old a knife, like. Okay, what a solid idea, Winchesters. Can you imagine Jack in preschool trying to relate to these kids? There is fan fiction about it? I'm terrified, okay. But it'd be really funny, the kid would be like, do you want to play blocks? And I'll be like, we killed people yesterday, like, pretty cool. Yeah, I watched my uncle shoot a guy. That could be funny. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, so, since Jack is a hands-off kind of guy, if you could be a hands-on kind of God today and onwards, what would you do?
I mean, where do I start? You know, You know, this is like literally like the Miss America pageant, you know? She's like, world peace. But yeah, world peace would be cool, you know? Eradicate poverty, you know, running water for everyone, that'd be pretty cool.
Sounds great.
Also, I'm curious like what you thought the answer would be.
In pure supernatural fashion, I thought it was going to be something small and silly that you can't accomplish today because of the convention. I don't know, maybe you'd fly somewhere, do something.
Oh, I'd love to fly, that'd be great. Who wouldn't want to fly? No, I think I've kind of answered a similar question before, but I made it more like I was Oprah. So I was like, you get a car, you get a car. Also, I was giving away puppies last time. I think that was my plan. I was like, everyone leaves the convention with a dog. They walk out the door, and he's like, thank you for coming, hope you had a great time, here's an adorable puppy. And I'm just like, yeah. So puppies for everyone and world peace.
What was like to drive the Impala?
So you got your license, you passed?
Yep, for sure.
Good for you. That's nice. I don't think Jack took a driver's exam. Does he even have a social security number? We don't know these things. It was really fun. It was great. I just was so, I want to say honored, I guess, but like, there's only so many people who have driven that car. And I got to be one of them. So it was super cool. I felt like I was a part of the show's history in a way, getting to drive a car. Also, Jensen was like quite nervous. Because, you know, may have someone who's like a sane person, but then you put them behind the wheel and you're like, oh my god, I'm gonna die. Someone's like, yeah, that's me. Not to be trusted. It was really fun. He was definitely like, you good? I'm like, yeah, I think I'm good. I didn't crash the car, which is cool. The really fun part for me too was, for a behind the scenes thing was like, they had what they call like a chase car. So it's a car, but then it's got like this giant arm that holds the camera out. So it wasn't just that I was driving the car for the first time. I was driving, and then literally like a foot in front of me, there's like a camera, and you're trying not to look in the camera, and also drive the car, and also do dialogue. But it was just a really cool experience.
My question is, what was it like playing a character like Jack, who was portrayed as this innocent baby Nephilim, and then grew into his role as God?
Pretty cool. I don't know. Initially, I thought maybe the character would go evil, which I was kind of looking forward to. But no, it was great. I mean, a lot of growth for the character, especially when you wake up and know nothing, and then by the end, you're in heaven. That's pretty cool.
I was wondering, was it harder to play like the absolute jerk in the end of 17, or someone as innocent and clueless as Jack?
Well, one's a little harder on your spirit, because in the end of 17, I'm a real asshole. But then the problem isn't not that you're like an asshole for like, you know, a 2-minute scene. The problem is that you're an asshole for like 14 hours a day. So that was harder, because you're like, don't feel good about this, you know? But playing some sweet and innocent is nice, because they're like, cut, and you're like, that was lovely. Yeah, you don't feel shitty afterwards. But yeah, that's the job, right? It's like, you're making someone believe you're a piece of shit. So, as long as they pay me, you know, I'll be whatever you guys want.
Thank you.
Not that way, God. Vegas has tarnished your guys' minds, by the way. Hello.
Hi. I wanted to let you know you're phenomenal in your acting, starting at such a young age and then up, because you kept that innocence, the innocence of a child as you were growing up. And then I watched a movie, you were...
This is getting a turn, right?
You played in Green Arrow at the end, and I noticed you were a bad boy. And I was wondering what you meant when you talked to Thea as mom or mama.
I was on Arrow, and then there was a character that I was obsessed with, I started calling her mommy and mom. Not really cool. Do not recommend. I was also like, my character was like really into her, so it also was weird. What was your question? I mean, he was really turned on by her, you know? This is going great. I was just like, how can I make this as creepy and weird as possible? And I think, based on this question, that I succeeded. Yeah, hard to keep your innocence when you're holding a flamethrower, calling a woman you're into mommy. So,
Any characters that you wanted Jack to meet?
Possibly. Is there someone that you thought Jack should have met?
I just thought maybe Jack and Crowley would have been a honey.
Yeah, that's kind of the one that I thought would have the most potential for the show, and I think would be really entertaining, would have been Jack and Crowley having interactions, because he's such a commanding character. So I think their interactions could have been really, really fun. He was off the show by then. But that would have been great.
Thank you.
Thanks. I love when I say really inappropriate things and then I remember there's children here. Hello.
Hey, Alex. Hi. My question is, everybody knows you as Jack on Supernatural, but you also played in the Arrowverse. Which one did you like more to do, Jack or in the Arrowverse?
I mean, I think we kind of just covered this. That's fair, it's okay. I'm going to say, the lost phone is at registration. Go and get that, guys. I'm going to say that Supernatural has given me a lot more than Arrow, because guess what? I'm here.
You did a really great job versus being Jack on Supernatural. It's a bigger universe, but that's my opinion. I really loved you in there.
Oh, thank you. It was fun, and obviously it's hard to compare, whereas like I got to shoot Supernatural for 3 years, well, 3.5 of the pandemic, and Arrow I only shot maybe 6 or 7 episodes, right? So it's hard to compare.
Thank you.
Sure, thank you.
My question is, when you got the role, did you know you were going to be this popular and have all of us?
No. How could I predict that? All of this was very unexpected. For actors, your main goal is just to work and to like be on set as much as possible. So like people sometimes ask me, they'll be like, oh, did you know that you would get to do this? And I'm like, how would I have predicted this? Unless I could go to the future, which would have been helpful. It was all very, very unexpected. I was backstage today walking with Shannon, who's nice enough to help me out and tell me where to go. Every time I do this, like, do you guys ever have the thing where like you're watching yourself do something, like almost in a third person? I have that every single time I do these, so it is very, very surreal to be up here. Like hearing myself right now is weird. And the fact that I get to like do this is baffling. So yeah.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
Supernatural is the best show, and it's better because of you.
Oh, that's very kind of you. Yeah, like what did I do to deserve this? I'm in disbelief, and these aren't funny answers. Thank you all for being here. Is what I'll say. Some of the best advice I've ever heard was just shut up and say thank you. So I'll just do that.
I was wondering, how did you prepare for Jack's final monologue with Sam and Dean and Inherit the Earth?
Kind of crazy, because we had that break in between filming, but I had the sides on my phone, and I just kept reading. I mean, what do? You read it over and over again. I was really focused on the raindrops part, just how he's in everything. That was kind of my favorite, what I thought was like the most poetic part of the speech. How do you prepare to like say goodbye to someone? How do you prepare to like, what do you say to someone who's dying? Like, I don't know. So I was trying to put myself in that headspace, and it was overwhelming, for sure. No one likes goodbyes, you know?
Thank you.
Thanks.
I was wondering, what was your favorite scene being directed by Matt?
Yes.
Okay.
In our pulsating relationship. my favorite shoot of Matt, it was Matt Cohen's first episode. I was so excited for him and so proud of him. To make that step is really a big deal. My favorite part of filming it was, they're like cool guys like Aaron Jensen, and they always like kick down doors, and they always look really fucking cool doing it. I finally got to break down a door, but I did it so poorly that it was horribly embarrassing. Because I'm like, this is my big moment. Like, this is gonna be so cool. I'm gonna storm in. Like, it's gonna be great. And I literally, they don't tell you how to do it. So they're just like, yeah, just hit the door. I'm like, cool. So I like, I didn't know. I was like, it's a door. It's gonna be hard. And I just like threw myself into it. And I absolutely flummoxed and just landed on the floor. And like, Misha ruined the tape by laughing. And like, Brad, our camera operator, was like, because I just threw myself through this door, and I was like, gotta recover, gotta be Jack again. They're like, cut. I'm like, I'm sorry. I really thought this would be cool, but you know. But thankfully, Jack's awkward, and I'm awkward, so it worked out.
Does Jack see Castiel like a father figure, or he sees him like he sees Dean or Sam?
I think he relates to Castiel kind of the most, just because, you know, they're both not of this world. So I think he had an immediate bond with Castiel that way, and, you know, he was kind of a trench daddy, if you will. I'm still working hard to make that work. If you guys see Misha, please refer to him as such. I want this to just permeate. It's working? Sorry, I got excited there. I think he saw him as a father figure for sure. But I think towards the end of things, I kind of referred to them as like, I'm like, my cool sexy uncles, you know? Not as heartfelt, I know. He had a different relationship with all of them, and he obviously came to like see them as family, especially, you know, being a Winchester and such. They took Jack under their wings, even though I have wings. It was sweet. Again, chosen family, you know? Thank you. Of course, thank you.
My question is, between Mark and Rick, who do you think was the most sinister Lucifer?
I mean, I got to work with Mark, so I think I'm a little biased, obviously.
In your own opinion.
Yeah, I mean, Mark. Yeah, Mark was like, I mean, I thought he was like one of my favorite people to watch work. Every take was different. He's unpredictable. I just thought he's fantastic. I felt so lucky that I got to like work with him one-on-one. When I would read scenes on the sides or from the script and they'd be like, oh, it's, Lucifer and Jack, I would, like, be excited and nervous because I was like, he's that good. I'm really biased, obviously.